Welcome to Unscripted. We are all being fed with the idea that the customer is always right. And we believe that the customer should tell you what exactly you should do in your business. Some even suggest that you go into the market, study the market, understand the market, know what the market wants before you can ever come up with the product. All those philosophies are fundamentally wrong in themselves. Why should I say that? One, if someone says you should go to the market to know exactly what the market wants, which is from the perspective, the first principle perspective that the customer is always right, then if you go to the market as early forward notice and ask the market, what exactly do you want? They will say they want fast houses. They won't think in terms of car. That's why you have to be innovative. So that is settled on the part of innovation. On the part of sales, if you think the customer is always right, in the first place, the customer will have got your product in the hand is right. In the first place, the programmer will have picked Tamoku ahead of Erosonic. But it's because you go ahead into the market and make a persuasion and convince the customer and change their rightness, their supposed rightness, to the new right. You know, now, let's assume they are never wrong. So, their rightness, their previous right, to the new right. So whether you want to agree with me or not, there should be one right, which is the new right of the fact that your product is better. So anytime you believe the customer is always right, whether from innovation perspective or from the sales perspective, and then what is the business? The business is fundamentally creating product and selling it. Everything in between are just crowd of events. So it's about creating and selling. So from innovation perspective, when you say the customer is always right, you want to get the feedback of the customer to work on your product, that doesn't work. You need to innovate. You need to fundamentally understand what the problem is, not what the customer says the problem is. And then when you think from sales perspective, if the customer has been right from day one, they won't come to the new light of your product. And if you think from customer relation perspective or customer success perspective, that is, when you are dealing with the customer and the customer just say you are foolish, you are stupid, there's a limit to what you can take. And the customer might be wrong by approaching you to say you are stupid. And it's about how you position your value and how you set your... How many of you could be able to pick a phone and call Mark Zuckerberg, my Facebook account has a problem? That's not possible. So if you have set your product up fundamentally strong enough, you really have the problem where the customer has to lash you, and then you accept the defeat that the customer is on this right. So from all those three lenses, I don't know any other authority and what they have to say. From all those three lenses, it is fundamentally clear between you and I don't want to know whether you want to agree to that the customer is always wrong. If that's not correct, that the customer is not always right. So let me leave you that part of this flip. You know, that is, the conversation changes when you think it very fundamentally enough. That is, when you are innovating, it's more about you seeing the problem. And when you are in sales, it's more about you creating a conviction, creating a perception that the customer will accept. At the end of the day, as a new right. And then when you are in customer service, it's about you ensuring that you have a prolific product. You have a product that's so good that it sells itself. So good, no one has to complain about it. You are the UI, maybe you are building a tech product. The UI is so good, so simplistic, so interactive. The experience is so awesome that you really need someone to complain about the fact that they click the button and it doesn't work. So if you think this, all of this, from first principle perspective, you see that you can ensure that the business is always right rather than the customer. So let me leave you with that and do have a wonderful week. We will have another flip by next week. And this is Unscripted, and I'm Timmy Brain. Timmy, today. Cheers.